Hey, you! Hey, you!
But Charlamagne the God, don't have people call my phone. Now, you boy, you very influential, boy. I'm getting a lot of calls behind you boys. You boys very connected. Now, I know I'm right that y'all in that damn boys club. I can tell you that, boy. But I swear to God, I can't even look at my phone. My phone been on Do Not Disturb all day. I done missed so many damn calls because these niggas calling me. I got motherfuckers calling me from the East Coast to the West Coast. Everybody telling me to leave these niggas alone. Ah, damn. But guess what? Nope. Because they said they wanted to have a fucking joke time. We gonna fucking joke. Yeah, y'all said y'all were joking. I'm joking too. I'm just joking a little better than you, nigga. Fuck you talking about. Now you niggas don't want to joke no more. And boy, I wish you wouldn't have told, boy. You want to sit there and tell my whole family killers and watch out, Kwame Brown so hurt by basketball, even though he ain't mentioned shit about basketball or convincing us or nothing. Let's just throw that in there because we think people dumb. We think people would believe that same old fucking broken record ass story. Even though I told people what y'all idiots was gonna do. But Charlamagne, that pressure on you. Cause boy, there's some smoke brewing up under your ass. Cause Angela, you got a decision to make, sis. Sitting here acting like you goddamn like black women. You goddamn, that's sad. You got this patch-eyed demon. You got that patchy eyed demon. Cause I still like the nigga with the patchy eye. But that's probably around the time that you was riding that patch on your eye. Cause that's when you felt insecure. You know, right eye. You felt insecure when you had that goddamn patch on your eye. So now that maybe you healed, now that it'll bleach your goddamn skin even, boy. Maybe you don't feel so damn unpretty. Hey, look here. It's funny how you punk ass bullies can't take nobody talking back about y'all. And then y'all so stupid. That's a damn shame. Y'all some mental midgets. Y'all put these motherfuckers. Y'all, it's just amazing to me that I told the people what y'all were gonna do. And you some bitches been doing it every single fucking day. It's a goddamn shame. Charlamagne, I'm not gonna get up off your ass until you tell me who protecting you, boy. Cause they just as bad as you. See, I think Angela Yee, I think that light-skinned punk, DJ Envy, that nigga that need a leash by his wife, I guarantee you, when that nigga go home, she put that nigga on a leash. You look like you in that S&M shit, punk. Where she whoop your ass for cheap. Every time you come in there, you want some. She probably beating the dog shit out you before you get some. Nigga, you gotta get a spanking before sex, boy. That's a goddamn shame. You gotta get a spanking before sex. You got to go ahead and leave, Henry. You ain't gonna never be able to be a man around that woman, punk. You probably go there and cook, take, you do everything, don't you? Forget you nothing, nigga. You done cheated on me? Fuck, I look like making you some breakfast, nigga. Why don't you get the bitch you fucked 20 years ago and get you some breakfast?
Damn.
Everything you say probably revert back to that, huh? Okay, baby. Nigga, the next thing I want you to say out your mouth, nigga, okay, baby, that's all you supposed to say to her, nigga, you punk. You sitting up on a show talking about you love black women and you got the nerve to talk about Kevin Samuels and I don't like when somebody talking about women and this and this and that. But you like when your punk ass co-host take advantage of them with Spanish Fly and get on the goddamn air and talk about it. Nigga, fuck y'all nasty, sick son bitches. Sitting here trying to say somebody crazy when everybody can see that you nasty motherfuckers are sitting around here being the bad boys club. Yeah, y'all niggas got pics. Everybody can see y'all got pics now. Certain niggas you can't talk about like they fucking superhuman. Everybody wanna rally together and whip. Since when you motherfuckers start worshiping humans? You motherfuckers worship people more than you worship God. It don't make no sense. You motherfucker, it's some of you niggas that are swing on motherfucker about another man. You mother, they can't be the daddy that ain't in your house. See, we gotta fix this shit. You got a bunch of these feminine males going out here looking for these goddamn somebody to be their leader and their daddy. Shit don't make no goddamn sense. I wish I would fight about what somebody said or argue with somebody said over another nigga. Man, please, I got too much shit going on my own. But you goddamn Charlamagne, you thought you was hot shit just the other day, flipping down your glasses looking like a little bitch. Boy, I know they be tying a rope around your neck, you little punk. Every time you sit in there, they make you look like a little goddamn schoolgirl, sitting in there blinking and shit so many times and smiling and smirking. What the fuck is wrong with you, what? It's like one of them boys, whoever goddamn making you stay out of jail, boy, it's like they dressing you or something, nigga, because you starting to look more sweeter and sweeter, nigga. You ever heard that song, nigga, by John P. Key? Sweeter than the honey on the honeycomb. Sweeter than the honey on the honeycomb. Charlamagne is sweeter. I'm gonna tell the world about it. Sweet ass nigga, you fucking with me, what? You should have shut your bitch ass up. But see, you just proved to the world that it's a bad boys club, because nigga, I wasn't talking to you, nigga. And just like Jemele Hill, nigga, you should have stayed out my motherfucking business, punk. But no, since you brought your little punk ass over here, and you got some nerve, boy. You really got a big white zaddy, boy. You know how cocky and arrogant you are, boy. A couple years ago, you had the nerve to taunt the woman that you took advantage of, punk, on the radio. And now you think you so in the clear that you got the nerve to talk about somebody else's past when you a whole-ass predator. And then Angela Yee and DJ Envy, both of you motherfuckers, sit there and act like y'all like black women. Boy, y'all niggas sad. How can y'all motherfuckers sleep at night? How can y'all sleep at night when y'all got sisters and friends and all that you know damn well you can't leave around Charlamagne? You can't invite that nigga over because y'all might have some wine and that nigga in here dumping shit everywhere. Around that nigga, you better take your goddamn... I don't normally recommend you taking glasses and shit in the bathroom, but around that nigga, you better take your shit in the bathroom. You leave your shit out there around that nigga if you want to, then 3 minutes, your ass will be asleep. Thank you for the super chat, guys. Hey, but look here, check this out. In 3 damn minutes, you'll be knocked out. And that nigga talking about, oh yeah, we had sex. She had sex back and everything. How the fuck somebody sleep can have sex back? You, this nigga so nasty, his own goddamn wife. This nasty son of a bitch, he must want everybody to submit to his ass. You must don't want them motherfuckers to see that ugly ass scar you had on your goddamn face. So the only way you get hard is knock them out cold. Now, I ain't got to laugh at that. But like he said, he married her. So you knocked your wife out cold and you happy to tell that story. You stupid son of a bitch. I hope you don't go home and tell your kids that they grow up and ask how you met your mama. You better not tell them this story, you punk. Well, I just... Your mama, you know, and then, you know, she kind of liked the D, and then after she liked the D, she really didn't like it, but, you know, she felt bad that she already did it, so, you know, in order not to feel like a hoe, you know, she just kind of did it again, and then she like, all right, what the fuck, this nigga going somewhere, I guess. Now, see, y'all thought I was playing when I said, nigga, don't fuck with me. I told you I was geeky, and I told you niggas to shut your goddamn mouth. That's what I said. You know, I'm getting good at this YouTube thing. Pretty soon, I'm going to stop cursing so much. I'm trying. He ain't doing me yet. Then I'm going to be monetized like a mother trucker. I'm working on changing, shut your god mouth to be quiet. <Ooh. coughs> Snow Punk. They tried to check me. Look who they roster. They tried to check me with.
All right. Crazy. Now, first of all, I'm going to have to edit the video. He did drop the R word a couple times. So we're going to take that out because it's YouTube and YouTube don't play no games when it comes to that. So we're going to edit the video. But listen, man, Kwame Brown, boy, you got the juice now, son. You got it. So this man, and salute to Kwame Brown, by the way. Salute to Kwame Brown, okay? He came on this YouTube shit. He did what he needed to do. He made sure his voice was heard and he applied pressure nonstop. Okay, so the clip that I just played, yo, this shit is crazy though, because this man is doing a lot of exposing. And what's crazy, it's all facts. It's all facts. But people are acting like this shit didn't happen. Or maybe people forgot it actually happened. Charlamagne did mention exactly what he said about his wife. Like, that's a true story. That's a true story. But long story short, man, this man applied pressure to Charlamagne and he caused the man to apologize. And salute to Kwame Brown for holding it down as a man. All right? He applied pressure on these fucking bozos and now they apologizing as they should. But it's just crazy that all this shit actually transpired. Charlamagne the God is still employed right now, but everybody else is getting Me Too. But Charlamagne the God is protected. Just because he apologized, does that mean anything? It shouldn't mean anything because it did happen and the truth is the truth. Listen, man, let me know like what you guys thought about this video. If you haven't yet, like and subscribe to the channel. I'm going to be reporting a few more videos on this story because this is an ongoing thing at this point. So if you want to keep up to date with it, subscribe to the channel. It's your boy AQ and I'm out, man. Peace.